Previously on Quantum Break.
We're taking the hard line. Any potential threats to our plan need to be erased.
They're here to kill me?
No, but you're coming with us. We need your expertise.
No.
I'm not asking. Get her on the boat. I'll keep him busy. Come on, Cole, hurry up!
She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay. Sophia's data's always been good. I'll trust her judgment. We need to analyze these figures and make final preparations to activate the lifeboat protocol at once.
Fine. I'll take the laptop to the science department.
No, I think I'll do that myself.
You took the one thing Mr. Serene needed to survive, Dr. Amaral. That made you priority one.
Yeah, they made that clear. Monarch lined every escape route with barricades, roadblocks. I had to get to the mainland, but I couldn't do it by car. Needed a new plan.
All right, let's go.
Beth, I think I'm gonna need a ride. The streets are too hot.
All right, where do you want me?
I'll let you know as soon as I find some higher ground and get a good look at the situation on the bridge. I think it might be a no-go. Gotta get to higher ground.
I'm looking at the bridge right now. It's a lot of monarch. I don't know, maybe you could sneak across?
Well, maybe.
Or I could pick you up. Let me know. I'm pretty exposed out here, so try to make it fast.
I'll be a lot better when you get me on that boat. Monarch's right on my ass. I'm not exactly making friends out here. How's Dr. Amaral?
Still kicking and screaming. How long do you need to get here?
That depends. Let me check. Paul. What the actual fuck? Better get inside before the chopper spots me.
Still there?
Yeah, just looking for a viewpoint.
So, we don't know where he is. We can't find him. So we need to look into a replacement.
All ponies are made of butter in Night Springs!
There is all of us, lots of the Kratzu things happening. In Gitu of Niget Springs.
Thank you.
All ponies are made of butter in Night Springs.
We know the old dance, the fortunate and the destitute.
The haves and the have-nots. Those who dine at the table and those who starve in the street. But the tables can be
turned. The gluttonous consumer may find himself the consumable resource. Do that again.
And yet, that is the fate that awaits you in Night Fringe.
It's Night Springs.
Night Cringe.
Springs.
Bright Springs.
Night Spring.
Fright. Winge.
Jesus.
We know the old dance. The fortunate and the destitute. The haves
and the have-nots.
Those who dine at the table and those who starve in the street, but the tables can be turned, the gluttonous consumer may find himself the consumable resource in Night Springs.
Right things.
On Joyce or Wilder. Doing another sweep.
I can't stay here long, Jack. You're gonna need to be quick.
Yeah, about that.
Bad news?
Reoccurring theme of the night.
I don't care.
I'm looking at the bridge right now.
If we let Joyce across that bridge, we're pixels.
It's getting tense
Don't
out there.
What
if I go anywhere near that thing, there's gonna be a caught crossfire.
Alright. Anybody's ideas?
You and our fire! There's no way in hell you're gonna get away with this!
Calm down. You need to take a look at your truck.
Let me see. There's a pier under the bridge. You should be able to meet me there with the boat. Giant gas sign out front. Can't miss it.
It's nice and bright for Monarch to see.
There's not a lot of options. Switching to Monarch frequencies. Be in touch soon.
All right, I'll be there in a few minutes. Don't stand me up.
Okay, how are we getting down there? Where's the fire pole?
Bobby's back, and we're getting reports of more and more of these Monarch roadblocks springing up all over town. What the hell is going on in Riverport tonight? We've got a truck driver from Lucky Joe's Treasure Trove on the line. Great morning.
Stop waiting here!
You bastards.
Don't touch me! Let her go!
You're hurting her!
HQ, this is Gatekeeper 1. Sleepies are up in arms over here. They're getting out of their cars. Some asshole from Lucky Joe's won't let us search his truck.
You heard Serene. We take the hard line. Easy on the trigger finger, but if it comes to it...
Copy.
You have no right to be doing any of this shit! My brother's a boss, okay, man? Don't give me that book! You explain it!
Hey! You down there! Don't come up here, man! Monarch's got this whole place locked down!
Target has been spotted under the bridge.
Thank you.
up here.
Keep your sights on that dock. He may try to escape by water.
Shit.
HQ? The civvies heard gunfire. They're freaking out up here.
Beth, change of plans. The pier's too hot. Gotta find another way across.
Almost there. Just wait 2 minutes.
I'm not putting Dr. Amaral at risk. I'll make it across that bridge. Whatever it takes. Need to get up to the bridge. Cross it.
We've got civvies trying to push through the line.
You know your orders. Hard line. Any means necessary.
Okay, good. It's cool. Just gotta make it across the bridge into the thing. This is so bad.
I knew I'd be dead if the stutter collapsed while I was in the frozen crash. I had to reach solid ground, and the deck of the cargo ship was my best bet. Just had to find a way down. Frozen crash was a mess. Somehow, I had to find my way across. Hope for the best. Kept heading downwards, towards the cargo ship. The route down wasn't exactly user-friendly. The fracture was getting much worse. Timelines getting scrambled. Caught in violent loops, off sync, crashing into each other. This was what the end of time would look like. Everything was broken, in chaos, frozen. And no one would know.
Okay, come on, come on, come on.
Objects were moving out of time, out of order, entire timelines overlapping. And it was gonna get worse, unless we could stop it.
You don't understand the power you're wielding. You need to hand this technology over to Monarch. I've prepared for what happens next.
You say you're prepared, but no part of this plan of yours involves stopping it from happening.
Even if I fix William's machine, what could you possibly hope to achieve? The end of time is coming. There's no way to—
Hey! This isn't a debate. I just watched a ship fast forward through a fucking bridge. Time is running out, and the fracture's getting worse by the minute.
And it cannot be stopped. Paul has been to the end of time. He's witnessed it firsthand. Can't you see? We prepared for what's next out of necessity.
Your research is based on work by William Joyce. You respected him. He knew that the fracture would occur, but he also knew that it could be fixed. Will built a way to stop the fracture. This. The countermeasure. We're traveling to the past to retrieve it. You can help us get there faster. Or... you can agree to disagree.
I'll have to run diagnostics on the machine. I can't promise anything before that.
Nick, take Emerald to the machine. Keep an eye on her.
You got it. Welcome to the team, Doc. Don't make me shoot you.
Jack, before we head downstairs, we have to talk about something.
Okay, what's up?
It's about the plan. If Amaral gets the machine working...
We go back to yesterday and undo all of this.
Listen, in the video Will left for me, he said the countermeasure was stolen from his workshop on July 4th, 2010. He also said I took it. Maybe I did, Jack. We have a time machine.
You're saying we go to 2010. We steal it.
If Will was right, that would mean it wouldn't be a change. We take the countermeasure, bring it to the present, fix the fracture, save the world.
Okay. Explain to me why that's a better plan than just going back to yesterday and preventing all this from happening in the first place.
Because I'm afraid that based on what I know about time travel, we can't change anything. The past has already happened. We can't change it. But my way, we don't have to.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, my plan still feels simpler. Let's just get the machine working. This was the guy delivering the speech at the gala.
Name's Martin Hatch. According to Monarch Radio, he's been deemed a traitor. Sabotaged a Monarch lab.
Potential ally?
Not even close.
Dr. Amaral seems convinced that Paul's been to the end of time. Do you think that's true?
Can't be. Otherwise, trying to prevent it would be pointless.
Why?
Because it's already happened.
Let's see how Dr. Amaral's doing with the time machine.
Yeah.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
You think Will told her about it?
No. Will was never the kind to open up.
I can relate.
Will takes it to the next level. When we were kids, the only way that Will could express anything important to me was by informing my stuffed giraffe when I was in the room.
That's precious. And weird. Did she find anything?
I'm not sure. I'll go check. How's it look?
The problem is quite simple, really. The power relay is down. You'll need to find a way to reset it up. There, where the light is. I'll lower the ladder for you.
What happened to the power relay?
A power surge occurred at 7 a.m. this morning, when the machine was activated.
7 a.m.? That's hours before we even got here.
Well, the numbers don't lie.
Okay, I guess I'm doing some climbing.
Sure. Saves me from volunteering.
So what was the deal with the power thing?
The power relay is down. You can climb the ladder I lowered to find out what's wrong with it.
You've been loyal to Serene for years. How do we know we can trust you?
My loyalty has always been to the future. I will dedicate myself to whatever assures our survival.
You're not mad at him. Even after he turned his back on you.
Paul's doing what he believes is right. The same as you.
When he came to see me in that cell, he said something about the end bringing new dangers. What did he mean?
Monarch was built to protect us from what comes after time stops.
What exactly does Monarch think is coming?
When the fracture escalates further, you'll see for yourself.
Console here's got two red lights, one green one.
You'll have to reset the power to the two stations with the red lights before activating the relay. Both stations are located above the machine. Just follow the cables to the red lights.
Above the machine. The perfect place for a reset switch, Will. Okay, the first red light is now green.
Good. One more to go. I'm not sure if you can reach the second one that way. You may have to climb down and reach the other side of the machine.
How do I get to that second red light?
You may need to find a way to the other side of the machine, and climb up from there.
You're not mad at him, even after he turned his back on you.
Paul's doing what he believes is right. The same as you.
Hey, Jack. Come check this out.
Hey. Shouldn't you be keeping an eye on Amaral?
Yeah. But I figure what I'm doing is more important.
Okay. What is all this?
I dug through the area and I found everything I could on your bro. You gotta see this video I found, man. Check out the TV. And everything else, I put on those tables over there.
Any news on Monarch out there?
Well, people are pissed as hell, but Monarch seems to be looking for you pretty hard. Been asking on a bunch of forums about your whereabouts. You want me to throw him off track?
Sure. Post that I was seen hiding in a catering van or something.
Love it. Consider it done.
What's on the computer?
I've been posting my theories about Monarch on a bunch of forums.
Oh, God.
It's cool. I used an alias. Blanche McDougal. I'm a chick.
is. It is. It's February 28th.
Jesus,
1999.
Will.
William Joyce.
1999.
After months
first experiment.
Of arduous work, my machine is finally ready for human testing. Ready is defined by me, since ready is obviously a relative term when you're dealing with the deformation of the chronon field and recreating of black holes' mass density by, you know, tangent. Okay, in short summary, I built the time machine, and it works. I'm gonna prove it, or die. Okay, just need to make some final preparations. When I enter the machine, I will travel clockwise around the corridor. Okay, core is active, chronon levels are stable. Travel clockwise around the corridor, exiting back into the same location in the near future. This clock is set to my watch. Now, when I exit the machine, there should be a significant difference in time between my watch and the clock in this room. Corridor is locked in place. Okay, setting the date to 5 minutes to the future for the first test. Now, admittedly, traveling to the past would be much more impressive, but I can't travel backwards in time, only as far as the first activation of the machine's core, which is, now. Okay. Machine's ready. Monitor is stable. What I'm about to do is gonna change the very fabric of...
Was that Paul?
That's how he arrived in the past.
Well, how's that possible? It wasn't even the same time machine he entered at the university.
That's one question I still don't have an answer for. Looks like he tested time travel with rats first.
Why am I not surprised that Will's hamster was a test subject?
Looks like Schrodinger got a raw deal.
It's Will's journal. Everything's in here. All the secrets he kept from us. If he just told me about all of this, I could have...
It's best not to think about that.
He spent 11 years building that thing. Abandoned everything else, including me. Now I know why. I try to forget that period.
Oh my god. Please say there's a CD.
Dude, I already got it in the stereo.
Yes!
Check it out.
God damn it, you guys.
Wow. You know, this song really speaks to me.
Uh-huh.
Your true weapon is obviously the healing power of your music.
I mean, it's not even that bad. I could totally bone to this.
Thanks, Nick. You've got to be kidding me.
What is it?
This is all my stuff from our family home. kept everything.
Hmm. Guess he thought you might come back.
My artsy rebel phase.
Complete with a very rebellious how-to guide. Always wanted to try this, actually. Never had the time. Is that...
Yep. Will's personal psychiatrist. Wanna give it a try?
I think that giraffe's holding enough baggage. Jack? You okay?
Yeah. What's wrong?
Toto. That's my signature.
You made this?
I've never even been here before.
That woman in the picture is you, isn't it? So...
Jack. There's something you should know. 1999. I was 8 years old, playing in my backyard, and a woman approached me, told me she was from the future. She gave me very specific details of events that would come to pass. She gave me this. Filled with dates, events, proof of it all. Jack, that woman...
It was you.
Everything I told myself would happen, did. Every detail, for better or worse, came to pass, and couldn't be changed. Our fate is laid out before us, Jack. Everything that happened to get us here, every sacrifice that was made, they're all a part of this path. And they can't be changed or undone.
Beth.
When we step in that time machine, you will see for yourself.
All right. If you're that sure about how all this works, we can try it your way.
Notebook was full of dates, events that would come to pass, instructions. Her entire existence was formed out of those pages.
Her. She's the one who's been painting all over the city. Jesus. Looks climbable.
controls way up there.
That's exactly the kind of question that never would have entered Will's mind while building this thing. Hey, I think I can get to the reset from here.
Of course.
Shit. I'm still getting used to that.
Don't expect to. All right, all lights are green.
Functional.
Okay, we're doing this. I'll set the data into the console.